You can't tell me that ain't, you know, waterproof test right there. All right. Greetings and salutations. Hey girl, hey, what is up? Today we're gonna be doing a waterproof makeup look for all the fun summer activities we all have ahead of us. Some pool, some beach, salt water, chlorine, whatever the heck, all the vitamin D occasions. I personally don't usually wear too much makeup to these situations, but I do understand there are situations where I would like to look a little bit more composed, a little snatched, a little fresh face, a little, dare I say, glowy. And these are some products that will last, because that's what we want. We don't want half our face to be out in the water or half of it to be sliding off. And if you're new here, you should know that I am all about the waterproof testing. If a formula claims it, we're gonna test it here on this channel. Plenty of mentee reviews as receipts. So we're gonna start our face off with our skincare. So I've been using this new Verst Weekend Glow Daily Brightening Moisturizer for the last week or so. It's supposed to be good for dullness or dryness. I am more of an oily skin, slightly combo in the summertime gal, but this is great because it has the vitamin C already in it. So if you're just kind of in a rush, you got your moisturizer and your vitamin C, which is good for brightening, also giving you antioxidants, and also really good to combo with your sunscreen to protect your face, help that barrier. This has a beautiful glowy finish. So we're gonna grab a little bit of this and apply this to the face. I'll show you one side first. Doesn't feel heavy. It's affordable. Available at Target, and that's just what we're gonna apply all over the face. I'm gonna put a little bit more on my neck and my shoulders. And then my favorite sunscreen for the last year or so has been the Tula SPF 30 Protect and Glow. This is a gel base. It is a little yellow tinted, but it blends out into a transparent. So I'm taking a nice good amount. It actually looks a little cottage cheesy, but it's gel compared to cream, so it blends out really, really well. I'm gonna take this all over the face, and as you can see, it doesn't give you any sort of white cast. Good for all skin types. Available at Ulta, their website, and also Ulta Beauty in Target if you have one of those near you. A lot of my locations don't, unfortunately. But I can still get like the Target deal. So I got an extra, this is a big tube, but there's like a standard size tube. I got one of those for half off. And I posted on my Instagram story when I saw it when it was on sale. So make sure you're following me on Instagram if you're not already. So this is what I look like straight up generally to the pool. But today we are gonna be aiming for the Clean Girl Aesthetic Makeup, formerly known as the No Makeup Makeup Look. These are the styles you'll see on TikTok, on Pinterest, and it gives you like a glowy face, fresh brows, minimal eye makeup, but you look really composed, cute, glowy. Let's do it. I have already applied just a tiny, tiny bit of my go-to Refi Brow Sculpt Gel, and that was just to kind of get my brows like upwards a little bit. Not as much as I usually would, but enough so I can put some brow pigment in. So we will be using a different gel since we are wanting a little bit more longevity, but I'm gonna bring you guys in close. The first thing we're gonna do is polish up our brows just a little bit. So I have two options to show you guys today. First product being the Redefine Brow Pen from Hailey's Beauty. So this comes in two shades currently. I hope they release more shades in the future. They have taupe and medium brown. I've used taupe before to neutralize some redness I have in my brow, but I typically use medium brown, and after 2 minutes this product becomes budge proof. It does not smudge, and even with water, not come off. Nothing. But you can take it off with the oil-based remover like the Micellar Water That's Blue from Garnier. That one has a lot of oil in it, and it's good for waterproof makeup or mascaras or lash glues that are just giving you a hard time. So typically I would use that and have no problems at all, but right now my brows are having a very bad week. Some weeks they're super easy, and this week it's not manageable at all. Like, I can't get the hairs to do what I want them to do. So we're gonna be using something a little bit more detailed, which is from Urban Decay. This is the Brow Blade. It has a pencil on one side, which is your standard just twist up pencil. And then it has a ink stain on the other side, like this. If you look at the aesthetic of the brows that we're going for, a lot of people go really, really fluffy with it and more of that soap brow look, which is something I already usually like to do anyway, but I won't be doing it to the gravity of making it a statement brow because I don't think that flatters my face. We will be sealing it in with something a little bit more heavy duty at the end, but we have to add our pigment first before we use that. So I will be starting off with the waterproof pencil, which looks like this. This is in Cafe Kitty, and I'm just gonna reinforce the bottom of my brow and the outer corner. We're also brushing it to kind of keep it a little less perfect at the top and letting the bottom be the good structure. So make sure you brush it out and you're happy with the shape and where you've put the pigment and the intensity before we seal it in. All right, so for the week we're having, this is as good as it's gonna get. So now we're gonna take the Makeup by Mario Master Hold Brow Gel. It has kind of comb bristles on one side and the regular spoolie on the other. This is stage makeup level hold. So I'm gonna brush up my brows kind of vertically and then start angling them out using the spoolie side just to kind of coat it. You can see it's making it a little bit more fluffy as well because it's getting the brows to stay where I would like them to. And then I'm gonna take the longer side of the brush, just kind of reinforce that. The pigment itself is gonna stay because of the formulation, but this is gonna keep the brow hairs from getting all jacked up in the water because I know mine would. Wipe off any excess residue so it doesn't stick to the rest of our makeup later. And those are the brows. The next big ticket item would be our eyelashes. So I will put on some mascara and show you guys kind of that intensity on my no eyelash having self. But if you do have eyelashes, I would recommend Milk Makeup's waterproof mascara. I really like this one. I think this one looks amazing, but there's so many great waterproof formulations that could give you a little bit of something without dripping all over the place, smudging on you, looking weird. This has a beautiful definition without looking clumpy or spidery or too much, and you can layer it beautifully. But I have no eyelashes, so that could do on a really low-key day. I'm gonna add just a little bit of extraness. Using the Kiss Falsecera glue, I will be putting clusters on, which is typically what I like to wear. I do have an older one that I'm gonna be finishing up before I open my new one, but just for you guys to know, here are the claims. The new way to lash: no clumps, no smudges, strips, damage, or mistakes. It has two sides. The bond side is non-damaging, and the seal side removes any tacky residue to lock them on for all-day wear. It is true, the bond side has a black glue. The seal side is clear. I've used this in a lot of my videos, but if you're new here, it's one of my favorite things. You have to seal it in. If you don't seal it in, it is quite sticky and it will get black residue other places. There's also a overnighter glue, which they recommend if you want to sleep in them. I don't want to, but let's say you're on vacation, you could totally do that. I heard it lasts just a few days depending on how you sleep and all that such, but if you really want that extra peace of mind, you could totally get that and lock it in before your water activities too. But I think I'll be just fine with this. And I wanted to try a new pair of lashes out today. This is the Ardell Lift Effect. So I'll just be slicing this into thirds and applying it as such. You could also use clusters. I have a lot of clusters from Amazon that I really like to use too, and I find that they make my money go a longer way than buying the Kiss ones, and there's more variety of styles. But the Kiss ones are good as well. So the lash looks like this on the model. What will it look like on me? So the band on these lashes are clear, as you can see. So I will be painting just a little bit of liquid liner on top of it prior to applying the glue, just so I don't have to have that peeking through on my lash line and it kind of just showing up all the time. That'll give more of a natural look, as you can see. And then just a little bit of the bond glue goes on there. At least that's how I like to do it for extra security. And then a little bit goes on to the bottom of your lashes, kind of like a mascara would. And you gotta work fast, one eye at a time. So I actually put the middle on first this time, which is not what I usually do, but it was the piece I was holding. I usually work from one end to the other. But that's as easy as it is. It takes a little practice, of course, but you just lift up your lid gently and apply it underneath your lashes. And then I pinch between each piece so they sit nice together. And I'm not gonna get really close to my inner corner this time. I typically have a very small piece like this guy right here. He's really tiny and I usually put that there, but for swimming I kind of want to keep my inner corners clear because I know I'll be like wiping my eye and I want to be able to have that just little space right there. So the last piece I am applying is a little longer, so I'm gonna overlap it with the middle piece, but if I shifted the whole look over toward my inner corner it would fit perfectly, so I don't want to trim it. I'm just gonna layer instead, just like that. And these are very light, which I'm happy to report. Of course, when they're gonna get wet, they're gonna look a little different, but that gives me a lot more definition than just mascara, as you can see. So I'm going to do the same thing to my other eye. So we're back. I typically see that however I apply it on this eye, it usually is a little bit more lifted, so I use a curler to even out the intensity. It also kind of pushes everything together and it gives you more of that like liner look without wearing liner. And now I'm gonna use the seal side, which has this thin little brush, and kind of just run it along the edges. I like to tap compared to pulling it high up because I don't like what it does to the ends of the lashes. However you want to apply it, just make sure you get all the spots that need to be secured. But the good thing is when you apply it underneath, you don't have to worry about anything on your lid getting dirty or smudged after you're done with application. So that part's lovely. Taking a second glance, what do y'all think? Even my contacts look similar to the models. Next up for our face, I'm going to be using a little bit of Milk's Hydro Grip Primer. This is a new bottle, but I'm gonna put this on spots where I would like a little extra help keeping my product on. So high intensity areas would be basically my nose bridge and where my acne scars are on my cheeks. I'm not gonna put this everywhere. Those areas should help a lot. It needs about 30 seconds to get tacky. If you want an affordable alternative, e.l.f. has the Power Grip Primer, which is very, very similar in finish and performance. So there's been a lot of videos going around with the new Makeup Forever foundation. People are using that a lot for their waterproof needs. needs. I personally cannot use that foundation. If you've seen my review, you can see why it doesn't get along with my skin, unfortunately. So I am going to be using concealer as our main pigment for our base today, and powder, of course. Something affordable that works quite well is the Maybelline Superstay Concealer. This is a new revamped 30-hour formulation, the active wear that has a lot of resistant proof claims to it. I did do a wear test if you would like to go see it. I'm gonna be applying the shade 22 under my eyes to brighten up that area, and also in any high points of my face that I would like a little extra lift to. And I'm gonna pat that in with a damp sponge from e.l.f. and work quite quickly because I don't want it to dry too much. I really don't need much product generally on my forehead, so that was just to make it look a little balanced. But this is absolutely a highlight shade for me. So after blending out that little light layer, I'm gonna add a little bit more where I really need it, which is in the hollows of my eyes, and let it sit for a sec so it can kind of dry just a little bit out on us. I didn't want to do that for the entire face. The rest of the face, I'm gonna use a little bit of Winky Luxe concealer onto my acne spots in light medium. So that's kind of spot concealing. I'm gonna leave the majority of my sunspots and freckles out. And for these little spots, I'm gonna be using a brush. And you can use a sponge too, but I feel like I'll get the most coverage if I just pat it in with this kind of fingertip brush. I'm also gonna take a little bit of the Maybelline concealer on this brush and put this onto the inner corners of my eyes because it is a little bit harder to reach with the lashes already on. But I want to kind of correct my dark hollows right there. I feel like it makes a huge difference as far as how like bright and awake I'll look, just a little better. So that's the majority of my redness and kind of concerning areas that I look for. Pulling out one of the big guns, also very affordable, the L'Oreal Infallible 24 Hour Wear Powder Foundation is waterproof. You could wear this alone if you want to skip all this other face steps. You could just use this and it works beautifully. Check out the review. I'm gonna use my sponge for the areas that I want to be really detailed, which would be where we just laid that concealer. This is in shade Sand, so I do know this is a little darker than my current face. So I'm not gonna apply it in our highlighted areas. It's actually gonna act as kind of a bronzer for me. You can use a brush, of course, too. But I want this to be nice and pressed in. And when you're using a damp sponge, you actually get more coverage out of it, leaving the center area nice and bright and bringing this down my neck, even over Miss Bug Bite. Putting this onto the sides of my nose. Something I love using when I start tanning up, because one, I've been too lazy to find a lighter shade, and two, it looks so good in the summer and lasts so well. Lighter areas, we're gonna be using Urban Decay's All Nighter Powder. This is in one shade, basically transparent, translucent, looks like this. Disappears almost instantly. Also grabbing it, trying to find a cleaner spot on my sponge. Is that even possible right now? Not really. I'm putting this over our concealer in our highlighted areas. This will also make you look super smooth. If you guys can see my face, it is wow, like, what pores, right? And I have huge pores on my nose. Once again, I did not cover up my sunspots much at all. That's just not the vibe for today. But this can go anywhere you feel like you need it. Go down the bridge of my nose with it a little bit, just to give a little dimension. And that's primarily our base. You can see it's quite smooth. This would be pretty even if you're not going to the water at all. You also have some options of adding color to your face. Rare Beauty has some water-resistant formulations. This is a liquid eyeshadow and the matching blush for that. So if you wanted to paint a little something, just blend it out with your fingers. That would be beautiful. I have used both these products in a different video when they first released, so if you want to see what they look like on, absolutely check that one out. I may add just a little bit of blush. I'm gonna warm up the product. This is Nearly Neutral, which looks like this. To me, it's still kind of pinky, but blends out beautifully. It does take a little excess, you know, tapping, so with that, I'll use one of these. This is like a dense situation. Grabbed a little bit, evening it out on the brush, and just bringing it back to the cheeks. Right here, adding a little bit more with my fingers. Obviously not the most ideal thing to do after powder. I forgot about it. It's okay, because you can just go over it with either powder. It should smooth it back in, and you have like a little flesh color. For highlight, I wanted to use this Jaclyn Cosmetics Skylight. This is one of their putty highlighters. It gives a very wet look. They repackaged it from their past collection. I do have it from that collection as well, so it's not super new to me, but it looks like a little powder, but it glows, boo-boo. It glows. I love it. Skylight is their glazed suntan color, so I'm gonna take whatever's on my finger and kind of just put it in the middle of my nose and blend it out with a cleaner finger. This isn't gonna be as waterproof, but once we seal it in, it'll have a little bit of resistance, and it's really gonna make that glowy vibe we were going for from our inspo photos come to life. So you can blend it in with your fingers or a brush, whatever you feel more comfortable doing. Definitely for the middle of the nose, I like a finger. And putty things things are a little bit more difficult to work with a brush. Like, you kind of have to be really patient with it, as you can see, but it's gonna glow for you, boo boo. You can see that spot that kind of wants to glow, that's gonna glow too. Cleaning off my lips a little bit since we're about to put something there. But before we do that, a step you should not skip: putting on the One Size Until Dawn waterproofing setting spray. This is a strong scent, but it's gonna help lock everything in. So it's more of a matte finish. It's not gonna accentuate the glow, but the water will do its job, the humidity will do its job, and this will also work in conjunction. So we're gonna apply this all over. So I like to do little vertical sprays, and then I'll do like a quick X. And obviously go over any areas that you really feel like you need extra. Maybe your neck is your issue and you're gonna wear some suit that's kind of rubbing against it. Maybe you want a little more on the cheeks. It's not gonna change the vibe too much, but it is gonna lock things in. And as you can see in this video, Patrick Starr is demonstrating that you can dunk your entire existence into the water with this spray on. So for lips, in a lot of these waterproof makeup videos, there are bold red lips. So I wanna do something a little different. We have options. NYX has a dual coating product, which is their Shine Loud lipsticks that have a gloss and a pigmented color. I think that's a really great option. I've been wearing my Refi Lip Sculpt quite a bit, which also has more of a matte finish, not glossy, but you can add a gloss on top of it. And this is also very, very pretty. So I could show you guys both if you don't mind bearing with me for a second. So this is in shade Taupe. So that's what the color looks like straight up by itself. I think that's really nice for something natural. It's not too harsh on the edges. It has a built-in sealer, which is clear and has like a paddle to apply it. So as you can see, I've gotten it dirty, but I can barely see the sealer. I like to use my hand and kind of get it into all the nooks and crannies. Both of these product options are transfer proof. So regardless if you want this color, this is a really cute option, I think. Looks good with the dress, maxi dress season. And you can use a gloss on top of it. They do sell a gloss for it. I have not purchased it yet. I'm gonna use the gloss on the NYX Shine Loud, and you can look just so you can see what it looks like glossy. This is a very slippery gloss because this is the coat for this lipstick, and that's what that would look like. So that's option one. So getting this off with my micellar water. So the three shades I have of NYX is Magic Maker, Goal Crusher, and Ambition Statement. I would probably lean in between two shades. Like, I'm definitely gonna mix in Goal Crusher. I think I'm gonna go Ambition Statement and Goal Crusher today. So I'm just gonna put some on my hand and work quickly. Goal Crusher doesn't look Goal Crusher-y to me. It looks way more pinky. It looks like what Magic Eraser is supposed to look like. So it's mixing those two together and applying it to my lips. As you can see, it's more of a finished appearance. Like, it has a little bit more shine naturally to it. You can feel it drying out though when it's setting itself. This is what it would look like without the gloss, but of course we're gonna gloss it up because I feel like it makes your lips look kind of pruney. And the gloss can wear down and you can reapply the gloss as much as you want, but it makes the formula way more comfortable. So wipe that around. Option two. This hand's luckily clean, but you just get gloss. And if you wipe the gloss off, this is what you'll get. It'll be nice and smooth since you've sealed it in with the gloss. And you go like this, sip your little drink, ooh. The last option is not a waterproof option, but it's definitely the most comfortable option. It's using these Jaclyn lip oils. I've been loving them since last summer. They released these three shades previously, and now they've been re-released as a collection. There's lighter shades. I think we're gonna use this one. This is a very, very comfortable lip oil. Something you would probably reapply, because again, it's not gonna be waterproof. This is Maple Drip. Huge applicator, but it looks so good on by itself, right? This is a good option. Fenty has some new lip stains that you'll see in my videos, which are good options. The only thing about stains is that I would apply it and then wipe off the glossy part immediately and just let the stain be the stain. It's not gonna last like all day, and you'll probably have to reapply, but I'd be concerned about the stain transferring onto something and getting stained like your swimsuit or something like that, because I've definitely had something like that happen when I'm wearing like a white swimsuit or something. All three would be great options. So before we spray our face down, let me know down below which of the three combos you really liked lip-wise. One, two, or three. They're the emojis. And without further ado, let's do it. Some people using garden hoses. Some people jumping straight in the pool. That's great. That's cool, cute. We're gonna spray with water. Continuous mister. So take a final look. Alrighty. You can't tell me that you know, waterproof test right there. All right, grabbing literally my favorite house towel because it's the closest thing to me, and just, there we go. You might lose a little on your nose, to be honest, because it's probably the thinnest part and probably the part that's gonna get oiliest, but you're gonna still look beat to the gods, like, yeah. And even if your lashes get wet, they will be on there nice and secure, brow still browing. So I hope this video helps you guys in your summer plans. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you would like to see one of my recent uploads, I will have them on the screen right now, as well as the subscribe button, which is free 99 if you would like to join our fam. Stay tuned for future contents. It's quick, it's easy. Go ahead and hit that button. That is it for me today. I will see you guys in a later video.